Hello, everyone. Today, I'm going to show you how to create realistic-looking hedges as well as rows of flowers in Twinmotion. It's actually a pretty simple task, so let's get started. Twinmotion has a couple of hedges here in the library. They're called Laurel Hedge and Leafy Hedge. These assets are greatly optimized, so they look very good from a distance. However, if you look closer, you can see the low poly count. If you need something which looks very good from a close-up, we needed to use another approach. Luckily, a new tool which was recently added to the program can help, and it's called the Spacing Tool. So we go into Populate, Spacing, and we're going to simply draw a spline, adding a few points. All right, now we need to add an asset to that spline. So we're going to go into the Megascans Library, 3D Plants, Garden, Flower List, and here you can find a boxwood plant, which we drag and drop onto the box on the right side. Now we have the asset placed, we're going to click on it, choose Split, and now we can select the assets which we don't need. We just want boxwood number 9. All the other assets can be selected and deleted, leaving us with one style of boxwood. And as you can see, it actually looks nice as a decoration of our garden. However, we're going to create a hedge from it. So what we need to do is we need to select it, go down a bit here to path tension, put that to 100 to make the spline into straight lines. Now we can increase the count to 100 assets. You can type in higher values if needed. And now finally, we can increase the random rotation so it doesn't look repetitive. And that's it, our hedge is done. That's all you actually need to do. Now let's create a second one. So we click Populate, Spacing, and draw a second line. This time it's going to be for flowers, so we keep it close. All right, for flowers, we can obviously pick from Megascans. However, keep in mind, we also have some flowers in the grass category. Here we have buttercups, which I'm going to use. I'm just picking it, and now after it's selected, let's put the path tension to 100 as well. And we need to increase the count and add some random rotation. The flowers are too big, so we need to scale it down quite a lot. We're going to go down to 25%, and now it looks pretty good. But we still need more density, so instead of 100, I'm just going to type in 500. And now you can see it's a perfect looking row of flowers, and our yard is done. Thanks a lot, and have a great day.